Yeah, I should have put on some pants. Doing this with shorts is kind of weird. But either way, it's kind of late at night, and I just don't care. So, update time, as usual. That was the worst start ever. Anyway, what's going on, guys? My name is Bossrosslp. Welcome to my little mini update video of sorts. Hopefully, it'll be small. I can't imagine it being too long. I have my list of shit I have to talk about right here, so. Fuck. Yeah, hopefully, it looked great. We got our nice little laundry list of stuff back there. I mean, look at all this stuff we have to do in our future. Although we probably aren't doing most of this stuff. Like, let me just take a random game off the wall, and I'll just give you a perfectly random guess whether or not we're actually going to be playing this game. Here, I choose you. I chose Guitar Hero World Tour. Yep, that is a perfect game that I will never be doing. Oh, I suck at Guitar Hero. Ironic, because that's actually where Get a Boom Mic comes from. It's from that game. Right back here. There it is. There's Get a Boom Mic all wrapped up. Nice. So, in the last update video of the shelves, we had just this guy back here. This one right there. Now we have this one. We have, in fact, upgraded ourselves, guys. We have a second shelf. It is the exact same shelf. I set it up. And it looks pretty fantastic. I'm rather enjoying how this looks. Hopefully this is being picked up on the mic. It probably is. Anyway, NES games, 3DS games, more NES games, DS games, didn't realize I had so many fucking DS games, N64, controllers, the Wii games, the GameCube games, the PlayStation games, fuck, the Xbox games, some movies. These shelves look fantastic. I mean, and he even has the picture of me as a little child. I mean, I know it's a little difficult to see, but you see the little guy right there? See him? Do you see how ripped he is? That's me. That's me. Not the fat one. That's Dalton. For some reason, he was fat back then. He actually was kind of big. I was just like, muscles. So, yeah, this is an update video. Just kidding. No, it's not. Alright. So, yeah, that's basically what I wanted to say on the shelf. Shelf's back there. That's really nothing. It's just for me. It's very visual. It's not really anything that needs to be updated on, but I figured this needs some closure. Maybe I'll zoom in at the very end of the video on, like, everything so you guys can take a look at my games library. Maybe, whatever. Anyway, I suppose we'll start updating shouldn't we? Anime talk show. That's probably the first thing that I should talk about. I said I was going to do it, like, episode 1 over spring break, and that never really worked out, mostly because of work, a little bit of laziness, but a lot of work, a lot of schoolwork I had to do, and the fact that a lot of shit was happening after spring break. Like, after spring break, I had to recite a poem, which took up quite a bit of time of me memorizing that. That was Robert Frost's Road Not Taken. The funny thing is, I still know the entire poem by heart. It's Two Roads Diverge in the Yellow Wood, and Sorry I Could Not Travel Both. And be one traveling along, I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where bent in the undergrowth. Then took the others just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim. Because it was grassy and one aware to ask for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay, and leaves no step had trodden black. Well, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubt if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Some are ages and ages hence, two roads diverge in a wood nigh, I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. I've said that at least 3 times in like 3 separate recordings. I think once in Skyrim, once in Tales, and maybe a third time in Skyrim. I don't even remember where else I said it, but there you go. That is Robert Frost's poem that I had to learn. So that took up a lot of time during spring break. So with that being done, the anime talk show, I worked a little bit on it today. Not a whole lot, but it's getting work. Right now I'm in like the editing phase, so everything's recorded for it. That's really like quick. I can do that in like 2 hours. The main thing that needs to happen, though, like with the editing phase, I separate that into phases as well. Like right now, I haven't edited like anything major. It's really just taking all the mistakes that I had during it and editing those out. I didn't really do that when I did my first anime talk show, and I think that's a large reason of why it took me so long to do it. So hopefully that will be done. That will be done. It will not take too long to edit that down. I can't imagine it taking too long anyway. I can edit about 10 minutes every 30 minutes, so. That'll take a little bit of time. You'll see how long it is when it actually goes up. That is Rurouni Kenshin's anime talk show is the one I'm talking about, episode 1. No really reason to call that spoilers. Anyway, projects. So, what's ongoing on the channel right now? Let's see, I got 4 ongoing Let's Plays. We got Paper Mario, we got Tales, specifically of Graces. We've got Metroid Other M, and we have Skyrim, there you go. So, oh, I should probably put my, yeah, there's 4. I'm not doing 4 over here, boss, it's 4 over here. So those 4 projects, how's everyone going? Well, Other M is going along quite nicely. Someone did a walkthrough. I was looking at that a little bit. I believe I had to look it up when I got stuck with that stupid fucking wolf ball part, which will be going up in a little bit. It should be on the way. Basically, that was like 30 parts, and even though he was rushing through it, I kind of get the feeling that mine's going to take roughly 30 to 40 parts, somewhere in that ballpark. I've only uploaded to 4, but I have probably up to like 10 recorded, or maybe more. So I'm maybe a third of the way through the game, maybe, give or take. I don't know, it's Metroid, it's hard to tell. But that's not really that totally important. I don't assume there's going to be 255 missiles like in like Prime. I only have, what, 25 right now? 24. Alright, enough of that. But yeah, Other M is going well. Skyrim is going along. That's just going to be a long donger. There's really nothing I can do about that. Graces is going pretty good. There's nothing much to say about that. And of course, Paper Mario is actually completed. It just has to be uploaded entirely. It's already fully rendered. No more space on my computer. Not even like dedicated to title cards or anything like that. It was the I don't give a shit Let's Play. I didn't even bother with title cards, so. That is that. That is basically the main projects that are going to be going on. But hey, it is summer for me. And even though I have 4 going on, I could technically have more because it's summer. Yesterday was my final class, technically final, which it actually was a final, so I had 6 classes, technically, and only 3 of them were finals, technically. Technically it was like 4. 2 of them, no finals, 1 was like a paper and nothing attached to it, and the other 3 were actual finals. 1 was like writing a paper, 2 were actual tests, so. That was fun. I took the bio one yesterday. That was a little difficult, but whatever, I'll live it. So yeah, that is the end of school, actually, for now, until fall. That's actually going to be a long break. Not until, like, Anne heads off to Floridia. Not until I go on vacation for a week. That is going to be happening in August. Nothing to really worry about with that, though, you know. So, that's pretty much that. There's nothing much to say, except for future projects. There are some that I am thinking of. I mean, a big part of why I organized like this was so I could just have everything here, you know? Everything, like, here and ready to look at. For example, this little fucker right here. You see this guy's right there? That is DECA Sports. I'm probably gonna have to flip the camera so it actually is readable, but this is DECA Sports. What is DECA Sports? Exactly. This is perfect streaming material. I played this game maybe twice. The only thing I remember about it is that it had a kick-ass theme song, and that's about it. So there's a lot of games, and it just helps to have a visual of everything, so I could just look at it and just pick a game and play it. That's sort of like what I did with Other M, although I actually bought that off Amazon. Not for pretty cheap. It was hilarious. I actually bought that for like maybe $11. You know what? It might be considered a pretty bad game, but $11, it's Metroid, it's Nintendo, that's pretty worth it. I go into Walmart yesterday looking for like a Bluetooth adapter for this headset right here. This headset is amazing, and I would love a Bluetooth adapter for it. So I went looking for one in Walmart. They don't have one, whatever, so I don't know why Walmart doesn't carry those. More importantly, I found Other M, of all things, on the shelf. A Wii game. It was like the only one. And it was like $40. $40.96? What? First off, the game was released in 2010. That was 5 years ago. Second, do they even care about the reviews? It's heralded as a piece of shit. How can you sell that for $40? I mean, this isn't like E.T. on the Atari 2600. This isn't like Action 52 or something rare like that. No, no, it's just... It's fucking Other M. Everyone has Other M. It's not that uncommon of a game. I don't know. So, that was funny. Really, just having all this organized is just helping me, look for future projects, definitely. Also, just making sure I don't lose shit. That's also pretty important. Yeah, as a kid, I did lose a lot of shit. Like, I can pick off a game off this shelf and probably it's lost. Well, not really, but WarioWare Touch, that's lost. Pokemon Pearl, that's a story right there for why that one's lost, but I can explain that in a different day. Different day indeed. That's really all I wanted to say about that. Like, future projects, I definitely have some that thought about. I know, like, in the last update, I had some that were definitive. Like, Path of Radiance, I definitely want to do that. And that's going to be the complete opposite of the I don't give a shit let's play. That's going to be, like, one of the ones that I really know, basically. It's one of the only games I think I've ever done a practice file on, technically. It was a little bit ago, but I practiced the game, and I'm pretty confident that that's actually going to be a logical let's play. It's going to be on hard mode. It's going to have, like, something special attached to it. It's going to be, like, reviewing all the units. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be... Sugar Convert. Well, no, I can pretend it will. But he did Xenoblade Chronicles. Holy fuck, he did so much shit with that. Kudos to him. Either way, it's summer. Project's going on. Streaming. Like I just said about that, I came down there. Oh yeah, there's going to be some fun with streaming. That's really all I have to say about that. Like, streaming is going to be continuing. I know I haven't really been doing that for a little bit. But streaming will definitely be fun. Maybe I'll see if I can hit up Zuba for that too. There are definitely some games I do want to stream as well. Though we definitely need to find some co-op ones off Steam. That would definitely work very well. Because, I don't know, just like me playing a game and talking to someone, that's kind of like, eh. Could just go across the street for hand for that. I want to do like co-op games. Enjoy the experience with others. That's what it should be. And other than that, I guess I could still do solo streams. It's not the end of the world to do those. I do enjoy my solo stream every once in a while. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's what I wanted to update on. Like I said, this was going to be a rather short one. It dragged on a little bit longer than I thought, but good enough. If I explained everything, I'm happy with that. So like I said, oh, that was a great throw. All right, let's see what I can do about this. First off, we need to move the laptop a little bit closer. That would probably help. Okay. Oh no, this is not gonna work. Mr. Heater, you're gonna have to help me. There we go. Okay. So, let's see if we can't get you guys a nice look at all of the games. Alright, let's start from here. Okay. So you sort of have to, like, do it like that. Okay. So, Xbox games, all that shit. Yes, I have Sneak King, don't ask. Animaniacs are awesome. Death Note's his own thing. You know, SpongeBob first season. Should have gotten the second or third one. That would have been awesome. Anyway, we're in the PlayStation section now. There's all that shit. A lot of these games I actually haven't even played. Like, Ghost Recon, I played maybe an hour of. Ratchet & Clank, All for One, I don't think I played any of. Journey, I played 20 minutes of. Little Big Planet 2, I played 5 minutes of. Let's see. Red Dead Redemption, I played nothing of. Singularity, nothing. Tales of Exilia, nothing. Chronicles, 5 minutes. Graces, we're playing a lot of that. Some PlayStation 2 games, actually. And that Japanese one that you can't read, that is Gash Bell. Yep, I wanted to get a Gash Bell game. Shove it up your butt, I wanted one. Okay, there's the Wii games that are nice and hard to see because they're in the darkness. Okay, we got it. Actually, you know what? Since they're in the darkness, boom! That helped. Actually, that makes it harder to see. Never mind. Let's not do that. Alright, you got Block Party. That game's weird. Deca Sports, like I said. There's Fortune Street. We played that once. Metroid Other M. I'm not sure why Metroid Other M has the most boring, like, times numeral font that it can possibly have, but it does. Like, all the other ones just stick out. That one's just like, Other M. It's trying to be edgy. Not even the cover. This looks nice. Alright, there's some Wii U games. I don't actually own Mario Party 10. That is Ian's.
This is like terrible. This is a horrible zoom in. There's a Simpsons game. There's Skyrim, of course. There's Amnesia.
All the way down here. Oh, now we're in the really hard to see shit. All right, maybe I'll turn on the light for this, just so it's a little bit easier to see. Very on the end, there is a Wallace and Gromit game, Tony Hawk Underground 2, Legend of Zelda Collector's Edition, a bunch of Tails games. There's Smash Bros., Super Mario Sunshine, SpongeBob. That game was awesome. Splinter Cell. I should actually play that sometime. That would be hilarious to play some Splinter Cell. Two Paper Mario cases, don't ask. Nicktoons, you already know the answer to that if you watch the Paper Mario stuff. NCAA football, I don't remember anything about that. All I remember is it took way too many like bites to save. Like, let's look at this. 220, that is disgusting. Metroid Prime, Medal of Honor Frontline. If I could get that game to work, that would be a hilarious game to play multiplayer. Oh, that game pisses off so much. Path of Radiance, like I said, awesome. Custom Robo, had the disc, doesn't work. Battalion Wars, I actually played that for a little bit, and then I got stuck on one level and I never played it again. That'd be a fun Let's Play to go over, maybe, in the future. Alright, now comes the hard shit to see, because NES games are a little bit trickier to look at. Maybe their covers are actually, like, you know, nice for once. They actually want to be nice. All the way on the end, there's Asmax, Adventure Island, Faxanadu, there's Fester's Quest, of course. There's Ghoul's School. There's some other shit. James Bond Jr., that's a fun game. I played a little bit of that. Although I've played more than a little bit, since these games are a huge part of my childhood. Most of these NES games. Second shelf of NES games. A lot of these are actually new ones. Like the Time Lord, Legend of Zelda. I never had that as a child. There's 3DS games. I don't exactly have a great library of 3DS games, but a pretty sizable one. Somewhat. Got Toon Link trying to hold all that shit back. Here, right here, all that, is all the games that do not have cases or are basically Game Boy Advance games. And I always threw out the Game Boy Advance boxes. I probably shouldn't have, but as a kid, I was too stupid to hold on to them. Anyway, here's all the DS games. We have quite the selection here. I guess because both me, my brother, and my sister had DS games, so we all got some. That's why it just all pooled in this one pile. I guess that's why there's so many GameCube games and so many Wii games. Well, not even any Wii games. Wii sucked. Alright, Star Fox Command. Bunch of Pokemon games. I have like five of the shit bitches. Though I don't think like any of them are here. Like, let's see. I don't have Pearl on me. I have Black. I don't have Blue Mystery Dungeon. I don't know where that is. I don't have Diamond. I don't have Ranger. Yeah, so just Black version. To be fair, that's the best of the five. Well, debatable. Pokemon Ranger was pretty fucking sweet. Namco Museum. I'm not even looking in the proper area. I have to, like, both look at the camera and all this shit. Tony Hawk Skate Land. I think that's what that's called. American Skate Land. Yeah. They actually had a rather decent soundtrack. I'm a little surprised. Had some Green Day shit, so it wasn't terrible. There's that Stormbreaker, Alex Rider. There's all the controllers down there. A little difficult to see. And finally, Princess Peach holding all the N64 games, which you can't see because N64 is fucking stupid and did not feel like having covers on their games or whatever on the side. Though technically I should just have the boxes, but I don't. And that is that. That is all the games. Yeah. There you go, Zooper. You happy? I actually have a zoom in on my face this time. We're done here? Yeah, we're done here. Okay.